When I went back and listened to yesterday's video, I found out that the quality of the recording was about as poor as it could be. I think there might have been one that was worse, but it was pretty bad with the clicking sound. And can't really apologize for it because it's the circumstances Shapeway's given to me to record these videos with you stealing from him and such. We got this recent bout of money from the man in California. I didn't get a Bluetooth ordered again. I want to. I've got one in the cart, but I never really thought about it this time because of the priorities we have with food and clothing and other needs for these children and warm bedding I talked about. And I guess even yesterday's video got some warm bedding and such with it, but even stuff for the children and clothing ordered, more clothing and stuff that they need to grow into, because I don't know how that things are going to be whenever this gets let loose for getting supplies. I know he's going to bring things here, but I don't know if it's over the course of time, because this with the 1290, we know this is going to go much past the 1260, meaning that's it goes into it past over a year later. So I haven't got the Bluetooth ordered. I hope to if more money comes in. But what happened yesterday was windy, so I have two microphones. I have one like an omnidirectional I plug into the bottom of the phone, but it don't work when it's windy because it's real windy. But I still leave the Bluetooth in my ear so I can hear when I hit the clicker to know if the video is recording. So yesterday I did not use that directional one because of the wind, and today I'm using again, although there is a little breeze coming and going today, but I got out of the wind here in the tree again the best I could. But it's not really out of the wind, I know from previous ones, because when the wind really picks up, it gets pretty nasty on the recording. So but today I got the microphone plugged back into the bottom of the phone, and I've got the Bluetooth in my ear to hear it, so hopefully that the quality will be better. But like I said, I can't really apologize for it. It's the circumstances he gave me. But the other thing that was unusual about it was my voice was so hushed. Nothing else changed. And other times I recorded the Bluetooth, my voice wasn't hushed like that. It parallels the thin hushed voice, of the 40 days at Horeb prophecy from my predecessor Elijah. But I want to make a correction. Yesterday I did actually make an error in it. I talked about those dual Mogen clamps, the Mogen shield and the Mogen clamp. The Mogen shield from Israel shipping on 10/10, which it did. But actually the Mogen clamp that from the chief seed of the scattered descendants of Israel here shipped the next day on 10/11, which with the opening wide of my mouth waypoint is for 10/11, which is amazing because it actually, the label was created at 8:40, paralleling the 84 days or 84 hours of my death and Yeshua's death at 3 1/2 days. The dual spaces would be 168 days or 168 hours. But 8:40, the label was created, but it wasn't picked up until 4:52 p.m. that day on 10/11. And I want to expand upon that. 8:40, that's 1 hour and 6 minutes. That's 66 minutes after 7:34 a.m. that day. For he sent the flood 66 years after he told his servant Noah and his family to start building the, he told his servant Noah and him and his family to start building the boat. Then there was 52 years of them building it. They waited 14 years for the dual spaces, and then he sent the flood. But in the 66th year, 66 minutes later, the label was created. But it actually was picked up or dropped off or whatever at 4:52 p.m. that day. Stars number 452 is my predecessor Elijah. I'm his end time Elijah, folks. 452. What are the odds? But that it was actually shipped the next day. So both of them didn't ship that day. They were both ordered. It was actually ordered and shipped according to the time zone in Israel. The Mogen shield was that kit, that $77 kit, plus the $31 in freight, bringing it to $108, 350 shekels, or the 250 shekels for the kit itself. All amazing numbers I talked about yesterday, but the quality of the video was not very good, to say the least, but I suggest you still fight, do it, and listen to it. Amazing details with these two circumcision clamps. Just look at this, 4:52 p.m. But wait till you hear this. This Mogen circumcision clamp for these first three offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed, it shipped from Twinsburg, Ohio. Twinsburg. I talked about yesterday the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zachariah, being circumcised with this clamp, and along with the twin Meher Shelah Kushbaz, twin with his twin sister Rachel, dual sets of dual twins. Wow, Twinsburg, Ohio. What are the odds? And put that with everything else in that video. Just listen to, if I do to listen, the poor audio to listen to it, because it's quite amazing all the details he wove into these two circumcision clamps. It'll be here next week. I can't tell when the one from Israel will be here. It just says it left Israel, which I'm going to get to that in a little bit. When it left, it's all it says, it left Israel. But shipped from Twinsburg, Ohio. Wow, that's big too, going with everything else. But yesterday's circumcision for three of these four offspring of his holy seed, from the twins, dual sets of twins. Wow, the twin, Meher Shalal Kushbez, and of course, twin sister Rachel ain't gonna be circumcised. Tie that into Psalms 118, where it says, I will circumcise them. In the name of Yahweh, I will circumcise them. It says it three strokes a time. Three, in the prophecy for me not dying. The prophecy, Psalms 118, and it says, I will destroy them. Look up the word, it's circumcised. I will circumcise them. In the name of Yahweh, I will circumcise them. In the name of Yahweh, I will circumcise them. Three strokes of man-child. Put it all together, folks. It's quite amazing. How could you not be here standing with his anointed? You don't believe. You just don't believe. In yesterday's video, I also talked about Noah's 110th day being 1717. And I talked about it starting. It flowed out from when the 110 days from when he shut off the rain. The waters kept coming from the center of the earth, but the rain stopped after 40 days and 40 nights. Well, the 40th day and 40 night was day number 327. 717 plus 40, 327. Pretty simple. Well, Yahweh just shut off the rains on day number 40, 327. I talked about yesterday. I'm pretty sure I said in yesterday's video that Meher and Rachel was day number 327 yesterday when I'm talking about this. But yesterday was also the 87th day of my toothache. I talked about tomorrow, meaning today, being the 88th day, but I don't think I talked about it being the 87th day. If I did, I sure didn't put the two and two together, because the 88th day of the year is 327. I'm just giving you some fun nuggets that I missed yesterday in that incredible video. What are the odds yesterday I'm talking about the 87th day of my toothache? Like I said, my toothache affliction is a lot more. Affliction has been going a lot longer than these 87 days. I mean, the dual shoulders are something terrible. But even before that, the frostbite and everything else. And I mean, I said we had need a warm bedding and clothing, because we've been fled in the wilderness, even snowed in up there for those 5 months at 9,300 feet, I think it was. Or was it 9,600 feet? I can't remember. We're snowed in up above in the White Mountains up there, snowed in. Lebanon ties into that. This is the foothills of the White Mountains we're in, called the foothills. But truly amazing. I missed that 327. I'm pretty sure I talked about Meher and Rachel being in the womb 327 yesterday, but I missed the fact that it would be the 87th day. My 2K, day number 87 is 327. That's amazing. But I did talk about the 110 days flow out from. To take us from 327, take us to 717 in the count of the flood, as it was in days of Noah. I also talked about how he's been weaving 319 into every day lately. It's just every day, even today. But yesterday, when I got done, I looked at the news. I looked at the news, and Fox News had a headline. Seahawks home stadium gets new name written on a stone, gets new name hours before pivotal game versus Cardinals. Pivotal game. Wow. The picture of this on Fox News, you could Google it, but the picture of this had a Seattle Seahawks fan standing with his back toward the camera, and he had the jersey number 319 on it. I don't know, I haven't watched football in a long time, folks, but as far as I know, the most numbers that anybody has, any player has, is two on the back. Now, maybe that's changed, and they have 319 now, but why on earth on that day when I'm talking about that, he just keeps pounding 319, pounding it. The back's toward Jakeway's house, but the back's toward the camera. 319, and he's got his feathers sticking out of it. He's dressed up like an idiot, of course, with feathers for the Seattle Seahawks, but with the dual wings of a great eagle and stuff. They're fled in the wilderness to build fort, deliver the man-child. 319 on the back of this man. But that's crazy. But I didn't click on the story. And I was doing the notes for this video, and I had written down the title of the article. In case you don't believe me, look it up. But I said, why didn't I click on the name, the new name of the stadium? That's got to be significant. So I had to walk up to Cell Range this morning and get it. And it says the Seattle Sounders. I didn't have to click on the article. When I Googled the article, this came up. But the Seattle Sounders, it said, although it says the previous stadium's name was Century Links Field, was set for a centurion, 100 years, that's 100 days. I think I even talked about yesterday, probably did I talk about 100 lining up to it? I meant to, but I alluded to it, but I didn't. But that's still huge in this. But the 100 foreskins that turned into 200 foreskins and such, but David. But the Seattle Sounders renamed the stadium, so from Century Links Field, but to lumen field. What lumen? The light. The light to the great, it was Mahershala Kush Bash prophecy. The light is standing before your faces. The light of the testimony of his word standing before your faces. The light of these first four offspring, bringing forth these four spirits of wisdom, understanding, counsel, and knowledge to pour out. And those that turn back to him. Amazing stuff. Lumen field. Wow. Went from the Seattle Sounders. I will no longer sound again. Sound again. Tomorrow's the seventh Sabbath, seventh silver trumpet assembly, that he stop echoing, stop sounding again, per Ezekiel chapter 7, the fifth day of the fourth month prophecy. Stop, I'll no longer sound again, and he stopped blowing his silver trumpet to call assembly. You're no longer invited. It's amazing. Stop sounding, I'll no longer sound again. That's why I translate echoing from his mountains, because you echo, you sound again from the mountains, but it says, I won't sound again. How that word should be translated. Well, from the Seattle Sounders, this the Google said, to lumen field, the light of the world. In videos, I've talked about that in the past. But this is before the game with the Cardinals. The Cardinals folks are from Arizona. I did have to look at that closer because they used to be from Arizona when I was back into watching football, so I assume they still were, but they still are. Anyways, risen up his house in the light of the world, his second son of his holy anointing oil, standing before your faces. In Arizona, in the northeastern part of this state. Announcement from the north and the east, northeastern part of this state, the southwest corner of this great Elohim forsaking land of America, the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel. But 319 on this man's back. Yesterday I said he just keeps pounding the 319. He does. I'm going to get to today too. Where he doesn't have, but that's just yesterday again. And then this guy got 319 on his back. What are the odds? In case you don't know what I'm talking about. Abraham drew out 318 refined servants of his from his house to go smite the four kings that had smitten the five kings when he went to rescue Lot, his nephew Lot. So 318 plus 1 is 319. Wow, feathers on this man sticking out of his silly jersey that had 319 on the back. Dual wings of a great eagle. Talk about the sea. I just talked about recently the two names for Rehoboam's son was one of them is my father is the sea. Sea of consumption, the Red Sea, it's mistranslated. I translated it before the Reed Sea, but it means the Sea of Consumption when you really translate it, the Sea of Consumption. But I converted yesterday's video at 10:52 a.m. When I converted, I'm talking about making it smaller to go onto YouTube so I don't have to take forever to do it. Wow, when I went to do the tweet, I just said, it marks what time I converted it. Went to do the tweet, I tweet the links for these videos on Z Elohim Twitter account. Tweet number 1052. What are the odds? But what does 1052 mean? Strong's number? House of those that are at ease. that ties into his 24th day of the 11th month prophecy, which talked about yesterday's video. Going to mention again in this video, but 40 days from today, day's 390th day, the house of those that are at ease. But that's part of that day. The horses go forth and the whole earth is at rest. But boy, especially the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel. I also talked about 11:17 in yesterday's video with China in relation to the 250,019 people that have died as of the day before the day before on 11:18, but the article was 250,019 that died in the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel. Well, that day that article was up was 11:18 for the second dove. I talked about that. But what I didn't talk about is how that first case of that virus back on 11/17/2019 in China was 367 days was this 11:18 waypoint. Say what? I talked about 367 in yesterday's video. The $367 that were brought into his house on the first of those dual 4 month long GoFund his house campaigns. Wow, I talked about the $367, 367 days for that 250,000. I talked about the significance of 250 with Korah's 250 princes rose up and the different things and the 250 price of a dog and 250 price of a whore and such. Why we're fled into the wilderness, but I can't reinvent the wheel in all these videos. 367 days because of the, you say, wait a minute, that should only be, because of the, 366 days because it's a day after? No. You got a leap year this year. 367 days because of the leap year. Adding that every four years, that leap year. Anyway, that night was that night the announcement was the 367th night. So yesterday's video followed the 367th night of the Abraham lamp. You just can't make it up. And that's what I did talk about, I think, in relation to $367. You just can't make it up. Dude, go back to the, in case you don't forget, go back to the ship from Twinsburg, Ohio, and go back to the 110th day and the 327 parallels, and go back to all of them I've talked to. Go back to all of them that I've talked about in the now 1,667 videos, including this one. Stuff like this constantly. And I only talk about a small percentage. I only probably see a small percentage. It's every news story, everything, every picture on the news stories. It's just crazy. It's crazy, crazy, crazy stuff. 4:52 p.m. for Elijah, that Mogan clamp. Well, the Mogan shield is significant too, maybe with him drawing out his dual nostrils. I'm getting to that. I also want to talk about an error I made yesterday. I said 7-1 was the last day of the 65 days. It was actually the first day of the 65 days, with the last day being 9-5. Anyway, for the 65 days, and I talked in relation to, at that time, I even talked, there was another tier of 65 days coming up, flowing out from 11-24. But anyway, I did make that error yesterday. I want to clear that out. But what that did was it brought me into another 319 parallel for you. 7-1 this year, the Memorial of Acclamations, plus 2 months and 19 days. Strong's number 219 is used four places. But 219 was the day that he caused me to begin to light the four lights at his house. Back in 5776 or 2016, began to light those four lights. It became seven lights. But Strong's number 219 is feminine at 216, which means lumen, to illuminate, lumen field. Wow, lumen. But 7-1 plus 2 months and 19 days for those four lights. And that even has significance. I'm going to go into 219 is translated herbs twice and light twice. It's feminine for 216, which is for lumen. Or the herbs is great for you. What are you smoking video? What you guys smoking with your marijuana? What on earth are you smoking video? Go back and listen to that one, even if you already listened to it again. What on earth are you smoking to think you're good to go with our maker? Anyway, four places, two places translated herbs, but one of them is to do with, the first one is to do with Elisha, in 2 Kings with Elisha, my predecessor Elisha's replacement for me, symbolic of me, Elisha, when they put those herbs, and the numbers there are amazing too, but when they put it, how it ties into this, but the number, they put those, they went out and to the mountains and gathered herbs, and the soup became poisoned. You're stoned because you've drunk off the foreign wine and fornication. You're poisoned. Your minds are poisoned with the lies that your father Satan and his servants gave to you. But you ate them up because that's what Yahweh gave you over to your rebellion, the desires of your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts. He gave you what you wanted, to live in rebellion to him. But you're stoned, drunk, four places, herbs. But anyway, it's you think you see the light, though, don't you? That's why his sense of humor is amazing. You're stoned, but you think you see that, stone cold, drunk, sober, drunk, passed out in oblivion, drunk, but you think you have the light. You think you're woke. Woke, the woke generation. Are you about ready to wake up? Find out that you ain't been smelling the roses at all. You've been sniffing some 219 with the false light. That's amazing. But I mentioned that, but 7-1 plus 2 months and 19 days, which, 2 months and 19 days is 319, is today's 10:14 waypoint. I told you, even going to hit 319 today. Wow, today's 390th day I talked about in yesterday's video. Wow, 2 months and 19 days, 3 equals 319. Over and over again, he's pounding this 319 stuff. 10:3, I've talked, excuse me, 10:10 talked about, plus 3 months and 19 days, is this coming 129, 1260th day that the wife fled in the wilderness. Wow, do we have to wait that long? I don't know. He keeps drawing out his dual nostrils. The drawn out dual nostrils is the steamboat geyser. That's amazing. The steamboat geyser has two vents, two nostrils, the north vent and the south vent. Wow, talked about it before. But steamboat number 125 is now over 9 days since the last is the 124 eruption. Being number 125/39, a tithe of these 390 days. I believe she'd blow today. Hadn't as of a little bit before I started the video. I checked before I left camp, but haven't checked here since I got out. I meant to. Forgot, but steamboat number 124 on 10:5. Wow, that one of those four waypoints for the opening wide of my mouth. Wow, the next day comes to me. Then the next day, 10:11, truly amazing. The Mogan shield left Israel. The Danites left the old capital of Israel, but left Israel at 11:25 a.m. on 11:19. It shipped on Satan's calendar. It shipped on 10:10, which was 11/16. It had shipped 3 days earlier, but it went to Haffa and it stalled. But after it left that day, now it just says it left for the United States. But 1:25 a.m. with the steamboat coming up. Wow. But 11/19, of course, 11/19 on Satan's calendar mirrors 11/19 on Shapeway's calendar, according to the great Maharshal Kushbas. And 11/19 on Shapeway's calendar is day number 319 of the year on his restored calendar. You just can't make it up. But it left at 1:25 a.m. So we'll see if steamboat blows today. I don't know. Will she? She could. Wow, 9 days. That's huge significance, too, with all wine between 10 of days and much, much more. At all wine still is, I mean, King & King's wine cellar has been out now since 9/10, the night of 9/10, the eve of 9/11. That's huge too, because that was the three smooth stone anniversary of the first time he and I were reviled on account of the manner he sent forth the manual man-child. But I don't know, 9/24, I talked about in previous videos, 9/24, I will shake the dual heavens and earth waypoint, the signature wing waypoint, each man slaying each other, plus 125 days will be this coming 1260th day. That's over 3 months away. I'll get to. Wow. But 9/24 was 4 months. When the 125 days is 4 months and 5 days, which is 4 months and 5 days is 5/5, that signature ring, that Isaiah 55 signature ring that I've talked about throughout these videos. But that's truly amazing, cool stuff. Didn't get finished on 2/4 panels today, so that was from yesterday's from the other panel, but the other two panels. But anyway, so I had to flip it over here. More stuff, maybe keep, I didn't want to do two videos, want to just do one, it'll be longer probably, but that's fine. Last night, night number 136 of the shofar, parallel in Abraham, was 136 years old when he was willing to offer up his only begotten son of his wife Sarah's womb, when he was 36 years old. Isaac means laughter. Boy, he couldn't get to the last laugh. But also parallels the 136-year-old Apollo curse that Justify broke with the six races. That's amazing. Broke the Triple Crown races, but the three races before and the three races of the Triple Crown, those six races, went undefeated, retired to be a stud horse. Amazing. If we stud horses stand up for your faces, you sure don't look like it. His holy seed issues forth from me. Oh, his holy seed would issue forth from you too, and you'd bring forth children unto him. But instead, you bring forth children to your father Satan. But amazing. But the Justify won the race 3 months and 19 days in the year on a Maker's Restored calendar. 3 months and 19 days is 4/19. That's whenever he the race was when he won the sixth race, the third race of that Triple Crowns, and broke the Apollo curse, I think, in the Derby. But he won the Triple Crown on 4/19, which is 3 months and 19 days, just over and over again. You think Abraham drawing out those 318 refined servants just might be significant? Maybe you should read John 3:18 if you think you know what John 3:16 means. Wow, he tells us because you don't believe into his word. Wow, he believes into his word. The word in the flesh is standing before your faces, just like his only begotten son was the word in the flesh. How much more so his second son? When his entire book is written upon me, his word says so. 88th day of my toothache today. Talked about yesterday's video briefly. 3:28, the Ark Throne waypoint. Jeremiah chapter 3 says his Ark's not going to be a factor here. His throne is. But 3:28 was, I didn't tell you yesterday, like so many other videos I have though, but 3:28 was the day he spent me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plain into your midst from Greece, per Daniel chapter 10. 3:28, day number 88 of the year. Wow. The sign of the dove, his restored counter standing before your face is the sign of the dove. And I didn't run the arithmetic to see how many days we are from it today. That just hit my mind. It would be huge. But two major toothaches last night. Major. I haven't had major ones in a while, but major that kept me up. And I'm going to get into one of them here, the second one here in a bit about there. But like I said, it's more, the affliction is more than these toothaches. It's been going on a long time, including these dual shoulders. And that's how he gets me laying on my right side and my left side. And it's you know, the 390 days on my left side, it's been hard to do. He said he's going to put bands on me with the 40 days, but my left shoulder's been particularly bad. So I try to lay on my right side because I just keep wanting, I keep looking at, this is the 40 days, this is the 40 days. Because, I mean, he wove into the 390, even bringing forth these children, different tears in this warning cry, warning after warning after warning. But there's got to be a final time with the siege of the chief seed that scattered the sins of Israel, the last 40 days, which today's the 390th day from me being fled in the wilderness on from 9/14. That's pretty amazing. Plus 40, taking us to 11/24, beginning of the 280 days of Zechariah prophecy. Ezekiel chapter 4 on my right side. But I'm going to expand upon that in a second. Today's at 1,707 days. The Swede and the Scotlander, no, back in Europe, you guys count the, and even in the chiefs, even in the physical land of Israel, count like the month first, 17, the days first, and then the month, 17th day of the seventh month, 1707, from my heart attack, talked about 717 yesterday, chief seat of scattered sinister Israel, say 717, the rest of the world pretty much, I think, says 17-7. Anyway, today 1707 from the heart attack. The heart attack was on 3, the reason I brought that up was the heart attack was on 3-19 of 2016 on Satan's calendar. You can't, it was 1-17 on our Maker's Restored calendar for the day he resurrected his only begotten son, but 3-19 on Satan's calendar. You just can't make it up. But after the second major toothache last night, it subsided. I had ice on it. And you guys think, why does he put ice on a toothache? I put it on my cheek. I don't put it on the inside. Of course, anything cold or hot just kills you if you eat. But ice on the outside tends to soothe it after a while. But it took a long time for both of those last night. But the two finally subsided. So I decided to see if Steamboat blew. So I turned on the phone. And sometimes I have a signal in my tent. I did. But the time was 4:11 when I turned on the phone. And she hadn't blown. But both wicks were going bright at my tent. And the wife just told me in her tent later, the 88 square foot tent, by the way, 88 square foot. I moved into the queen's tent because my tent became not very functional with things, and we needed it for the supply tent. So I moved into, because the supply tent got ripped up in the wind. So I moved into the queen's old tent because we'd moved her into a bigger tent with a crib, one of the four cribs set up for these children. I'm not knowing when he's going to bring these first. It's not big enough to put set up all four cribs. But both wicks were going brightly at my tent. And if they're going that, they make it all night long. But no wind or anything. Well, then at 5:52 a.m., I actually very seldom sleep, but I went to sleep. And that tooth subsided, and I had a dream about these semi-loads of hay I'm not going to get into and stuff. I was awake, so it was a vision. But I went to sleep, and the amount of nights in a row that three nights in the last 45 nights, I think, one of the wicks have been out. So it's not very common that the wicks go out. At the previous 45 nights, three nights, one of them had went out. So it's pretty rare. So one of them had went out in that period of time. But the time she came, she got up, she gets up earlier than I do because I meditate on things. And I got warmer clothes coming now, though, so I can get up too. But I wear linen, so I typically stay in the tent a little longer and study and meditate on things. But she got up and she blows the lights out, and she told me only one of mine was going. So at some point between 4:11 and when she got up, which is about 6:30-ish, I suppose, somewhere in there, about 6:30. But somewhere between 4:11 for Operation Grapes of Wrath, somewhere between 4:11, in case you don't know, he sent forth Operation Grapes of Wrath on 4:11, those 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath. Somewhere between 4:11 and 6:30, one of my lights went out. Well, at 5:52, I dozed off a little bit, but she heard a swoosh. From the east to the west, she said it sounded like it came from the east to the west. Whoosh. Well, 5:52 tied in the earthquakes yesterday, just yesterday in my study. But Strong's number 5:52 is used two places. And First place is used is in Genesis, where it says, "Why did Sarah laugh?" You can know for sure I'm going to bring forth these two children. It means for sure. Why did Sarah laugh? You can know for sure. It means for sure. For sure. This is getting ready to happen. For sure. I mean, some point in time in these next 3 months and 15 days, he's going to let this loose. He's going to stop drawing out his dual nostrils. The words that I say, drawn out dual nostrils, are the King James translates it long-suffering, the two words. It means drawn out dual nostrils. Drawn out, number 639, with a dual grammar notation. Drawn out dual nostrils. Steamboat Geyser. Wow. Now, with these 124 blasts of those dual nostrils. But he keeps drawn out through the Steamboat Geyser with the mattress, the Steamboat Geyser mattress going back. This video will be hours if I went back and talked, expanded upon anything that can make, if you haven't watched other videos, to make it make sense. I just can't do it. I can't do it. It's just impossible. I mean, I could do it, but it just would go on and on and on. I've got things to do. I got the 103rd truck to do today with the rolling thing, the Ezekiel chapter 10 rolling thing. I got things to do. It takes a while to even get the video uploaded and such, but especially this one that's getting long. But 10:1 was the seventh night at that time, the night of 9:30, which is the one smooth stone anniversary of the destruction, the one great evil of Ezekiel chapter 7, which is the destruction of his house of Isaiah chapter, going blank now, Isaiah chapter 35, I think, Don't hold me to that. It's talked about several of these videos. I can't believe I'm going blank. No, it's not. Anyway, I'm going. I got my mind's. You know, once my mind gets crosswired, it's hard for me to think of. I'll probably think about two sentences later. But 10:1, the seventh night, consecutive night of these cows talking like crazy throughout the night and into the morning, the a.m. Wow, and the a.m. was 10:1. They went on into the morning. That's why I count the night before as 10:1. Then they stopped after seven nights. And then they resumed again on 10:6, the night of 10:6. So, and into the a.m. of 10:7, which is 10:6 is the next day after 10:5 for the opening wide of my mouth. When he gives me the next day for the opening wide of my mouth on 10:6, the eighth night, they resumed, and now they went for eight consecutive nights. What's last night? 7 and 8, paralleling the seven shepherds and the eight poured out ones from Adam. Amazing. Of course, I'm out of wine, so those two tiers of 7, 8 there have passed, and he continued to draw out his dual nostrils. But amazing. But that night on 10:6, when they resumed, these cows resumed, was the night that they moved up the count where Trump got 232 votes now. They moved up, I think, whatever state they gave him, it's significant, but they gave him, they went up from 214 finally to 217, and it went up 15, I guess, so it must have been North Carolina they gave him from the north. That's a significant two. But anyway, they 232 for those 232 young lads that went with those 7,000 to go smite those 32 kings, and how that tied in. Even yesterday's video, I talked about those two. But that was, or I think, yesterday, one of the recent videos that wasn't yesterday. But day number 232, the significance of that, day number 32 on our Maker's Restored calendar is always 822. Well, 2 years ago, 822 was the day he sent forth Hurricane Michael, where he brought me into the world on the southeast corner of this Elohim forsaken land in Florida. Brought me in, where he brought me in the world, up by Tallahassee, is where this Hurricane Michael sped up and hit hard. But now you ain't seen nothing yet. 822, day number 232. What are the odds? Tomorrow's day number 252. Excuse me, Silver Trump Assembly number 252. It'll be the seventh consecutive silent Silver Trump Assembly. Wow, 352 is Ram, the year of the Ram's Horn release. How that ties into this? Ram, did come all the word, different words for Terabith come from that word? 352 for Ram. Tonight will be the 137th night of the shofar if it continues, which I believe it will. There are three people who live to be 137 years old, which there ain't that many people. He tells us how long they live, folks, but three of them were 137. That's a little significant. Moses' father was one of them. Levi, Moses' father was a Levite too. Levi was another one. And Ishmael, two of three. Amazing. But tomorrow will be 11:21 on the great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, Isaiah chapter 8. Take that which pertains to Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, write it on a great mirror. But 3:21 on our Maker's Restored calendar is always 3:21, the prison mattress, the steamboat mattress, all tying into it. So that's big. It's 11:21, the mirror tomorrow. But it'll be Sabbath number 252. Huge, the 252 sacrifices that they offered up over those 12 days to dedicate Yahweh's house in the wilderness. Huge, the 252 censers. You can look at it two different ways. You can look at it as the 252 censers. You can look at it as those 250 princes, Korah and Aaron's censer. Or you can look at it as those 252 men, the 250 men plus the two that died with their tents when the earth opened up and swallowed up Abram and Deborah, those 252 that went with, it's actually 252 that went with Korah. Tonight will be, tomorrow night will be that tomorrow's 252nd Sabbath or 352nd Silver Trump Assembly, seventh silent, huge, significance there of seven with the silence. Ezekiel chapter 7, I'll no longer sound again. Seattle Seahawks changed the name of their stadium from the Seattle Sounders, however that's called, to Lumen. Get ready to see the light and smell the roses when you do. Rejoice when you see the hand in Zubra with these seven. They're the seven eyes of Yahweh, his 14 spirits, his dual sets of 14, his dual set, seven sets of dual eyes, 14 eyes for these 14 days, of his final 14 days it will be. But tomorrow will be 1,335 days for Daniel chapter 12. Blessed is he who waits and touches the 1,335th day. 1,335th day encompassed day number one of the 7-day march around Jericho. That means 6 days later will be encompassed day number seven. But the 7-day march around Jericho that began on 2-1 back in 5777, which was 2017, That date was 328 on Satan's calendar. Great Meher Shlalkush Bazmir, day number 328. The Ark Throne Waypoint, the sign of the Dove Waypoint. Did he throw? I don't know why I keep saying Ark Dove Waypoint all the time. Ark Throne Waypoint. I've said it so long, and almost always I forget to say the sign of the Dove Waypoint, because that's the day he spit me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plain. No other sign will be given except the sign of the Dove. Now, of course, millions of signs, not millions, but countless signs, it seems, have accompanied me, especially the Ezekiel 24 sign, 10th day of the 10th month sign. Just expand upon several videos, the easiest of all of them. Why can't you believe that one? You can't believe he spit me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plain on 328 with his restored calendar. At least believe that when one comes to you at the 5 points of the sign, you can know the Madonna Gateway. No, that's too difficult for you to believe. But you believe you're saved by grace apart from works of Yahweh's Torah, don't you? Even though the entire testimony of his word condemns such filthy nonsense, such an abomination as that. Yahweh's straight and narrow path is perfect at circumcising our hearts. Perfect at circumcising our hearts. Come and circle around me like bees do, per Psalms 18, and have your heart circumcised. I'll circumcise them in the name of Yahweh. In the name of Yahweh, I'll serve three strokes of man child. Oh, did I tell you that it left from Twinsburg, Ohio, that Mogan clam at 3:52 that day, 10:11, amazing. Oh, did I tell you the other one, these dual clamps? Oh, twin clamps, you gotta be kidding me. The twins that show up on the news are amazing. There was one yesterday, I forget what it is, but twin everything. But how much longer will he draw out his dual nostrils? Like I said, long suffering means dual nostrils, steamboat, put the pieces together. Watch Steamboat. Maybe she's already blown. Maybe she blew while doing this video. Dual spaces, she has it before. Dual spaces of dual spaces of 1/2 hour, final 14 days. Well, today is tonight's 14th night of this 10th month. Is it the dual spaces of dual spaces? There's certainly other possibilities, but I don't know. There's certainly other possibilities as well, but this is certainly a possibility for a lot of reasons, because today's the 390th day. That way, tonight's the 399th, and the 40 days and 40 nights begin of Ezekiel chapter 4. Wow, it takes us to 11:24. Wow. What I do know is that 3 months and 15 days from today, is the 1260th day. That I know. The Virgin in the Sky sign, another sign will be given, but the Virgin in the Sky sign, the Yahweh sent forth after he sent his sign of the dove, out from the belly of plain, but much after, but he sent forth that on 9/23 of 2017 on Satan's calendar, 7/30 on our Maker's restored calendar. But 1260 days, that encompassing that, and this coming 1260 day, the wife's fled in the wilderness, that combines between these dual wives to bring forth the man child with these four conceptions, truly amazing, of this man child. I also know today's the 103rd truck with the Ezekiel chapter 10 rolling thing. Significant, 103, it's pretty significant. 103 days for his dual part count, his twin count to his Feast of First Fruits. That's amazing. You count seven Sabbaths from the Wave Omer, the 116 Wave Omer. That's huge too. Because like I said, 11:6 was 10:10 this year with the circumcision clamps and such. But 116 is the Wave Omer. So, seven Sabbaths should be complete, and from the morrow after the seventh Sabbath, you should number 50. Not too complicated. Takes us to his Feast of First Fruits, the day that Moses, his servant Moses, came down on his 41st day to find our ancestors playing the whore with the golden calves. You play the whore to our Maker with everything. Your children, your cars, your houses, everything. Even you're stealing from our Maker. You know better than the testimony of his word. You're playing the whore to him. Whores. Just what it is. But 103 days on his restored calendar, the dual parts of that count. You say, why didn't you just tell us 103 days? Well, because his rotations were altered, and it could have been 102 or 103 before, but with his restored calendar, it's 103 days, always. Always, because it could have been 29 days or 30 days per month before he restored his calendar with the altered rotations. But anyway, it's 103 days. That's pretty significant. We count 50. We got to count 40 instead of count 50 coming up from today. Today's 103rd trek, we could count 40. Think about that, Salah, with the four kings and the five kings and such, with those 319 men, including Abraham. I also know that 40 days from today is 11:24, and 65 days later is the 1260 today. 65 days a day for a year for the Emmanuel Manchild, Meher Shalal Kushbaz prophecy, Isaiah chapter 7, Ephraim being filled with terror. Amazing. And either way, I know that our affliction, because believe me, the wife is afflicted too. She's not afflicted quite on the physical plane like I am, but she still is. I mean, her feet have been really bothering her and other things. But she still has affliction even with the womb not being closed. It creates turmoil in her body and such. Per Isaiah chapter 66, and she certainly has other afflictions. But our affliction will come to an end soon, and yours will begin. The testimony of His word says so.